with the big girls, you're playing way over your heads, I'm telling you.
This is foul.
That is horrible. I didn't think it was that bad.
Kim Woodburn is the real deal, a career cleaner with 52 years of hard graft behind her. Aggie McKenzie is a leading household journalist who's super hot on home hygiene. Together, they're the nation's dream team of clean. Welcome to Bagnor Regis, a quaint, quiet resort town with a dark, dirty secret. And who's to blame for this betrayal of Bagnor? Students, that's who. Some say they're the nation's worst filth offenders. Well, these party digs certainly play host to four grade A culprits.
If something's not yours, you don't want to clean it up.
Yeah, I'll just distance myself from it and pretend it's not there.
I think the boys expect me to do the cleaning in the house because I'm a girl.
I don't actually live in the house, but I do make a degree of the mess.
Our lounge is so huge that...
I mean, it would be a crime not to invite people into such a big space to get drunk.
If it's a degree in dirt they want, these dudes are heading for an all-out first.
When you get up in the night, you have to put your shoes on to go to the toilet. That's how bad it is.
Mm. Wipe your feet on the way out.
It doesn't help when messy mates clear off to their own pads without cleaning up. Hey, Dave?
I don't tend to clean up as much as I should because they're not going to clean up their own house, then I don't feel like I should be cleaning up their house.
They're all meant to be enlightened English students, but the boys are sitting in the dark ages.
Women clean. Men just make a mess.
The boys expect me to do the cleaning in the house because I'm a girl, and... there's so many of them and only me.
Charming, lads. A desperate Hannah's put a call out to our professors of all things pristine.
Please, Kim and Aggie, come and help me sort out these filthy boys. We're not going to be students forever. We can't live in that sort of mess. So please, Kim and Aggie, come and help me and us.
We've got to do this one, haven't we?
I think it would be a lot of fun. And I also think we could teach them a thing or two, couldn't we?
Well, this guy on the end with the muscles, I could teach him a thing or two. Oh, it's worth doing this, Axe.
Oh, what? Let's go.
Kim and Aggie prepare for an epic university challenge.
Definitely this one.
Look at the weeds. This is definitely it.
Recycling bin.
Empty.
Oh, this is good. Come on.
They can't live here. This is foul.
The lounge is not only dirty, it's actually like a hazard zone. No respect for any communal space in the house.
That's all garbage. That's all garbage. Look. Oh, my goodness, another one.
They're certainly keeping the off-license in business, aren't they?
Oh, look. Oh, Aggie. How long has that been there? Look at the colour of it. Look.
Kim, I think you need to put this one on. I'll put this one on, and we'll get stuck into them when we meet them.
The dining room... the table is used more by mice than it is by humans, isn't it?
Do you think this is a joke? Or do you think they really do live like this?
Oh.
That's terrible.
It's filthy and dangerous.
Look, this is some sort of steamer.
Oh, that's what smells.
Smell that, smell that.
I knew there was something ponging bad.
The kitchen is horrible. There's mess everywhere.
Instead of eating and then washing up, we wash up and then eat.
Oh, the sink! Come and get a Oh my god!
It's so rotten. It's not holding together.
Oh!
Nor am I!
It was beans a long time ago in a former life. It was beans. So, with your beans, would you like a drink?
I don't shower in the house. I actually go back to my mum's house and shower.
When you crawl through that shower curtain, it's like
Russian roulette.
And look at the filth on this curtain.
What I found in the corner.
Oh, look at this. You see the men, don't you? Just doing the business, you know. Pebble dashing the whole place.
Kim and Aggie have seen enough. These scuzzy students are about to be signed up for some extracurricular activity.
Students, I accept, honestly, a bit untidy, a bit naughty, a bit partyish. This has gone beyond it, kids. It's vile.
It defines our lifestyle. We're on the go all the time. We've got what studying to do.
You're
got
what,
to
dear?
Eat quickly.
You're what, dear? What was that rubbish you just spouted?
Studying, eating.
You're on the go. Yeah. You couldn't work yourself into a convulsion, dear. Let's get the facts right. Now, when was the last time this house was cleaned?
I'd say about a year ago. I haven't really done much tidying since I've got here, so...
There's rubbish, there's stink, there's filth.
Mould,
there's mould and mildew. The toilet seat's been pebble dashed by you men who refuse to aim the right way.
I've got a good aim.
Don't play around with us, you know. Don't play with the big girls. You're playing way over your head, I'm telling you. Where's Dave?
Oh, he heard the word cleaning.
He's made her honour.
I beg your pardon?
He doesn't have to live in it. He just comes and contributes.
But you allow him to do it, don't you? We said our piece, you said yours. Let's get it going, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
Right, you're on. Oh, my God.
Yes, that's right. It's called work. Spelled W-O-R-K, remember?
That's good. Well done.
Come on, it doesn't look good already. Well,
let's go as far as you
don't get carried away. Oh, yeah. Oh dear, I'm so sorry. It's a dust, kids, a dust.
Don't strain yourselves. That's barely a pass. Can Aggie get these domestic dossers to break the student mould?
I'm going to take a swab here with this. Have you got any idea how unhealthy this might be? This is where you're preparing food, for heaven's sake.
We know it's disgusting, but you just get to that frame of mind where it's what's the point of doing it.
So I put the swab into this gizmo here, OK? Switch it on, and anything over 500... means that it's very heavily contaminated. So can you read that out for me, please?
That's 5,516.
11 times dirtier than at a dangerous level.
I really can't believe we live in that. 11 times worse than dangerous.
Yes.
Seeing those results in that kitchen sink was just... it was horrible. I had no idea it would be that bad.
Come on, Hannah. Believe me, this is one life lesson that's going to get harder before it gets easier.
People sometimes have the notion that if they're in the bath getting clean, then somehow the bath's getting clean as well. Well, I'm sending this swab to the lab to show these people that's very far from the truth.
It's time for our teaching assistants to lend a helping hand, and Hannah needs all the support she can get.
What are you standing there for? Go get a cloth, get cleaning.
It's really off-putting looking at stuff like that.
And there's one guy who's so late for the party, he's practically missed it.
Are you Dave?
Yeah.
Well, better late than never. Get in here. Oh, yes, dear. I've got a job for you you're not going to enjoy.
Oh, good.
Walk this way, none of you. And don't be late again. Come on, let's get going.
Dave's on detention for being late, and his punishment is to clean the filthy loo.
That's faeces round that pan and dried in pee-pee. You can pull that face, some of it's yours, isn't it?
Probably.
This is how we're going to clean it, my love. Bowl of warm water, teeth cleaning tablets, and you know what? Look what it cleans off teeth. Now, the next thing in this water, I'm going to put a squeeze of lemon. There's only one reason. I think it'll make the toilet smell nicer. Now, last but not least, my love, steel wool. This is a 00 steel wool, which will not damage vitreous enamel. Now watch this. Now these three things working together, I think, will take this off. So between pebble dashing with your pee-pee and pebble dashing with your bum end, dear, it's in a very sorry state. Now do you see how I've got that? Look.
That's fantastic, that is.
But it took me, I don't think it took me 30 seconds, did it?
No.
Now go on, lovey. Go on, let me watch that body of yours writhe over the toilet. Now, up, down, up, oh, yes, yes, oh, very nice. Now, isn't it wonderful, Dave, honestly?
Yeah, although I do feel like I should be charging them for this service.
are you, dear? You know, you could be doing all this here, you know. You could be doing all this, couldn't you?
Sorry.
Well, get up. Do your job.
Very droll, Dave. At least there's one pupil with potential. Thank goodness for Hannah. Leaving their head girl in charge, Kim and Aggie nip out for a study break. Word's got around. The girls are in town, and the locals are bringing out their filthy knick-knacks. Nothing's too dirty for our Cleaning Queens Open University.
Has anybody got anything dirty to bring up to me? Come on, my love. Oh, suede shoes. Have you tried to clean these? Keep a kettle on the boil. Don't burn yourself. Be careful. Oh, it works wonderfully. Put your hand inside it and just take your suede brush. Gently go the way of the gnat.
Is the steam going to wreck the shoe?
Not at all. Not at all. You're not soaking them, dear. You're just stroking them. It's really all it is. Suede anything. Suede cushions, suede shoes, suede gloves. They are lovely.
Next, anyone? Oh, right, hi. So, what have you got here? A plate with cutlery marks?
Yeah, cutlery stains.
What I'm going to use is some scouring powder. I'm going to get a damp cloth, some warm water, and put some scouring powder on the cloth, and then just go onto the plate, and using circular motion, just go at the marks.
Well, yeah.
This is a really good thing to use, the scouring powder, because it'll take the stain off, the mark off, but it won't damage the plate.
Okay.
There you are.
Oh, yeah.
All gone.
Yeah. Thanks. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Who's the next person? These are called high visibility jackets. What do you do to get this dirty?
Let me lay on the floor.
You lay on the floor, dear. Now, all I'm going to do is this, my love. Biological washing powder. Let me take this part. It's if I was putting it in a washing machine. Watch, my love. Take a bar of soap. It's right, do this. Mm. Now look, it's starting to come up, look.
Oh, look at that.
You see? Mm. I do all this with a bar of soap, but I can't be bothered to take the 3 hours, and I'm not doing it for you.
Coming up, our students get a truly shocking science class.
I don't want a boyfriend that looks like that.
But will these partying pranksters ever learn their lesson?
And, you know, just because you're students, you don't have to live in filth and horror. You really don't.
When it comes to home cleaning, students are about as useful as a chocolate teapot. Pete, Hannah, Dave and Adam's digs are one big fat fail.
This lifestyle can't go on, and especially if me and Peter get a place together after uni, I can't live like that for the rest of my life.
The trouble is, Hannah's not exactly being helped by her housemates.
Give him some polish. Oh. Anything to skive off, aren't you?
Luckily, our cleaning team has been taught well. Headmistress Kim has a top tip for her star pupil.
Right, off we start. One bowl, warm water, my love, a little bit of washing up liquid, and a little bit of mouthwash, a capful of mouthwash. Toothbrush if I need it, which I probably will, and toothpaste. Right, on we go. Now watch. How long since anybody cleaned this sink?
The last time was when I'd done it about...
You done it?
About a year ago.
You're not taking English, are you, dear? You've done it, you've done it.
I did it.
Did you, dear? I'd done it as well.
You do it, and then somebody else will come and mess it up, and it gets to a point where you just... Why are you cleaning everybody else's mess up?
I never understand why you kids can't work on a rotor system and all muck in it wouldn't take any of you long, yet you won't do it, will you? Now, can you see? Can you see? What do you think of this so far?
My God, that is such a difference.
Copying what I've done, which is not rocket science, will you come to here and do this half of the sink board? Are you putting elbow grease? That's coming off with my finger and a glove. Ta-da! Skip to the...
The swabs are back from the lab. Will these test results finally get our lazy lads in line?
Right, brace yourselves, you lot. You're about to find out the scary truth about what's going on in this DOS house here that you all live in. I took some swabs from the bathroom, and what I found there was lots of listeria. This is what it looks like.
It's quite pretty.
Pretty deadly, actually. 25% of people who get invasive listeriosis will die.
That's a bit scary, isn't it?
No. Do you remember when I took that swab from the kitchen sink? It was very heavily contaminated with staphylococcus. In extreme cases, you can get something called staphylococcal scalded skin syndrome. And just take a look at this. Within 24 to 48 hours, your skin becomes very red and sore. And blisters start to form, and they become filled with pus, and they rupture, and your nerve endings are just screaming.
I don't want a boyfriend that looks like that.
Yeah, I think that's pretty extreme.
So, whose turn is it to do the washing up then?
Rip up those revision notes. The boys are actually cleaning.
Look at that. Look, see? It's a fine bath, isn't it?
It's gorgeous.
Never be afraid of elbow grease, dear. It'll never do you any harm. Now look at me, for instance. All my life, clean, you see. Haven't you done well?
Well,
you've not got far
to
go, have you? Proud of you.
While the gang put the party back into polishing, our learned ladies are once again regaling the locals with a lecture on how to keep Britain clean.
Now, have here the household sponge.
Everyone's got one in their kitchen.
And if you don't keep this clean and spotless, you are very silly.
A survey revealed that the average kitchen washing up cloth contained 330 times more bacteria than your kitchen bin. So where does all this bacteria come from?
There's your sink board, your little sponges on the sink, and
a bit of raw egg. Now, raw eggs can equal salmonella. In fact, a survey done by the Food Standards Agency showed that 1 in 300 cartons of eggs sold in this country contains salmonella.
And you're mopping it. Oh, yes, I think I'll clean my sink board. Oh, clean the oh, yes.
And what do you do with your dirty sponges? Maybe rinse them in water overnight and think that'll do. Well, it doesn't do, believe me. That moisture, humidity, it's just a perfect breeding ground for bacteria. In fact, one bacterium can grow to 8 million in just 24 hours. And then later in the day, you think, oh, I better get the dinner going.
This is, my love, just a little bit of chicken, you see. Oh, look.
Lovely.
Oh, God. What do? You think, oh, get,
wipe it up.
Get the sponge out.
Good old sponge. So when you use that cloth to wipe over surfaces or anything in your kitchen, all you're doing is spreading the bacteria even further.
The answer to all this is keep your dishcloths, your sponges clean. You can put them in a dishwasher if you've got one each evening and wash them with the dishes. You could also soak it overnight.
In a little bit of bleach.
Cap
that
of
will
bleach,
kill the bacteria.
Cap of bleach.
So help us keep Britain clean and healthy at the same time.
Back at the house, the students are cramming hard. But getting to grips with this much muck takes a lot of bottle. And in this house, there's a lot of bottle.
Now, you lot probably like to think of yourselves as being good recyclers.
Yeah.
Yes, except there's nothing happening, is there? Not just about recycling, it's about using up the space well, compressing everything if possible, getting it all in the bin. We're going to start with the glass bottles. Now, they need to be washed out. Get stuck in, Hannah. Do you know why they need to be washed out?
Stop the bin men getting sticky dog.
That's right. Also to stop the smells and contamination. A good chain gang going on here. Excellent. You've got all these cans here. So the way to compress them, we're going to simultaneously stamp on them. Let's do it. Right, now the plastic bottles. Compress it as much as you can. Scrunch it up. Come on, use those muscles that you spend so much time working out. That's right.
put the lid back on. That creates a vacuum.
Good, you've done it. That's great. What a difference that makes, isn't it?
It's barely a third full, and if we hadn't squashed everything down, it would be up to here.
This student house is about to sit its final exam. But will it be a pass or fail? The dining room just wasn't making the grade. Now it's right at the top of the class.
Open!
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Yeah,
this
is lovely.
Dining room now.
Do you notice the smell? It's not mouldy anymore.
Just nothing. Oh God,
really fragrant.
Just to be able to sit down in the morning and eat breakfast.
Yeah. Without the mice running around.
Yeah, without clearing a bit of mice poo out the way first. Mm. It is going to be amazing.
You can live like human beings, can't you?
The kitchen's gone from one big black mark to top marks. Well done. 10 out of 10.
Oh, wow. I can actually see the hobs and they're white.
Are you going to be policing the place?
Well, I don't want to have to, but if they start slacking, I'll have to crack my whip.
It looks really good, so we're definitely up for keeping it like this.
I think if we let it slip now, that would just be disgraceful.
The bathroom was a student stronghold of minging mankiness. Now it's an education in cleanliness.
Come on now. Yes.
Oh my.
The shower curtain's not hanging off the ceiling anymore.
And all that slime has gone.
Oh yeah.
That's really fantastic. It's all clean and
clean like a bathroom should be.
The lounge was where these digs reached rock bottom. Now the education is complete. It's honours all round.
That is actually amazing. It's not just a room and a space, it's more, you know, it's an area that we can sort of relax in.
You think that you'll carry on having parties here?
No, they're not coming round. Go somewhere else.
Yeah, no crazy parties. I think we could have chilled out sort
of.
Like a soiree. And you know, just because you're students, you don't have to live in filth and horror. You really don't.
I think in a way we were all almost living up to our stereotype, weren't we? We were all students and we all just thought that's what we're supposed to be.
Well, we're leaving now. Have a lovely evening and a lovely time all together. It's been lovely meeting you. Look after this young lady.
Yes.
All right?
It's great, all this excitement.
Nice meeting you.
Love
it. Hello,
Jesus. Be good to her. Bye.
Bye.
See you.
Bye.
Bye. I think I'm definitely going to keep this cleaning up. Now it's like this, there's no excuse. Now Kim and Aggie have left, I'm going to crack the whip on these boys, stick to the rotors, and if they don't, I'll phone Kim and Aggie up for some much-needed discipline.
Now, definitely going to clean up, otherwise I'm sure these three will be on me, and I'll probably never be allowed through the door again.
I think we all sort of felt like the scuzzy students, but now we've graduated from the University of Clean.
Yeah. You've got yourself right depressed, haven't you?
I have.
You're daft, Epis.
Log on to our website for loads more tips. Or if you or someone you know needs Kim and Aggie's help.
Well, tomorrow night at 7:30, a celebrity come dine with me that, for some, is actually sickening. Next tonight, it's not the food that's causing the problems. Deadlines are looming in Dolce Vito Dream Restaurant.